everyone. Ian here, and behind me is a new listing of mine for a 2015 Jeanneau 57. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this yacht has to offer. Okay, so here we are looking at, seriously, the Jeanneau 57 designed by Philippe Brion. This is a very powerful offshore cruiser that is packed with a lot of options, and the current owners, being the second owners, have really done a lot of upgrades, making this vessel turnkey to do the offshore cruising. As you can see, we're starting out at the bow. We have this large windlass, double bow roller system. As we come up for a closer look, you can see the tack attachment point for code zero, asymmetrical. This really is a nice offset here. Factnor electric furler, and then making our way back to the starboard side boarding entry, you're going to see just again the beautiful lines that this yacht possesses. It's definitely timeless. It's a very fast, comfortable, stable offshore cruiser. I have documented with videos on other models over 10 and a half knots and just standard, typical wind conditions with the mainsail and headsail that this vessel has. So again, definitely one of my favorites. All right, as we board the vessel, I want you to look at a couple things. We have these nice stainless steel grab handles here. So as you're entering the vessel, you have something to grab onto. Large Genoa tracks on the side deck that are off of the deck itself, which make it really nice. These are fully adjustable from the cockpit. Another set of stainless steel grab handles, both the starboard and port side here up on the roof coach. And then again, you're also going to notice this flat area with a built-in non-skid. So maneuverability and walking around the boat is quite nice. We also have inboard shrouds, so our access way up to the foredeck is very, very easy. Lots of overhead opening hatches, and then we have this really beautiful sun lounge up here that we typically stow in the forward stateroom. This gives us access to our forward stateroom. It can also double as a crew quarters, which I'll show you down below. But back to that large Lumar windlass that we have here. We have all of the chain and road. This has all been marked as well too. But really amazing setup here. Also, we have a quick connect here for a washdown. But this will give you a nice perspective of that double bow roller system, the Factnor electric furler. This also has a backup system. So if anything ever happened to this, you can just unscrew this little cover here, put a winch in it so you can manually winch it in. Beautiful teak decks. And again, just the flow of the vessel is quite nice. So we have lots of entryways for midship cleats, entryways for our spring lines. This is a Sparcraft mast. This is a triple spreader. So as you can see, triple spreaders there, radar with a stainless steel protective mount around that, which really gives it that protection, wind point, wind speed, direction, everything on the mast itself. And then this is actually keel step. So this is when most of the manufacturers go to keel step mast. So it goes all the way down to the top side of the keel. Factnor, furling, as I mentioned, Sparcraft mast, really nice high-end Harken blocks. We have a Dyneema running rigging. So we have all of the best equipment found on this luxury offshore cruiser. Beautiful macrolon glass here in the front, and then newer bibini and connector that really kind of tie in this way. Also, you're going to notice this built-in step here, so you have access into the cockpit. But one thing that this boat possesses is a massive cockpit. I mean, it is truly untouchable on vessels, 60 foot, and above. I mean, it is really impressive. I'll talk about these winches here in just a second, but really just kind of want to give you the flow of how everything is here. I've dropped down the transom, so you can see we have access to our dinghy garage here. This is done with a switch right in the cockpit, making it very nice and easy. This stepladder lifts up, And then now we have access into this really large Zodiac dinghy. The owners have put a electric e-propulsion motor on it, and then you can see how it's also utilized as storage. There's storage below this on each side of this as well too. We also have a turbo air inflator, so you can inflate, deflate your toys, your dinghies, and a winch that to when the dinghy is in kind of the loading position, it'll winch it up into the boat. I have videos on this as well too. And then you let off the winch and then you just slide it manually sideways. But it's a nice setup, especially with that e-propulsion motor. Here at the back, we have our swim step shower. So this is our hot and cold valve, the faucet itself, LED nav lights, and shore power inlets on this side as well. All right, so giving you a great perspective of the cockpit itself. This is really impressive. The other thing which I like in the Bimini design, they've done this straight bar across here. They've added the two windows. So if you ever decided you want solar, that's easily doable. These cushions will also kind of fold up underneath each one of these. You have storage. This is a dedicated life raft storage. And this gives you access to our dinghy garage. I'm gonna first start out at the port helm, because this seems to be the simplest one, and then I'll get into more detail here. But we have the Raymarine multi-repeater. This will toggle through pretty much anything that you want to look at, from AIS, depth, speed, apparent wind speed, and gives you everything that you need. We also set it up so this is a second switch for your electric furler. So depending on what tack you're on, you can actually furl in from both starboard or port side, which I like. The factory just does it on starboard. We added this furler onto the port side, so it gives you the options of that. Now, back here, we have, you know, you can see four sets of electric buttons. This is fast and slow speed for your main sheet. So this is a dedicated main sheet winch. This is a dedicated Jeanneau sheet winch. So what I love about this is once you unfurl your mainsail from the cabin top winch, that are also electric, you come back here and you can control both your main and your jib from back here, and it is super nice. I sit in this position a lot. I have my helm, you know, right here in my hand. Your visual is quite superb. And then again, your main sheet and your Jeanneau sheet are led right here. You also have Jeanneau track adjusters that are set up here with its own jammer clutch. So again, really, really nice. As we're sitting here, we have emergency bilge pump, we have a water inlet, and we have upgraded stereo speakers. These are the Fusion stereo speakers. As I mentioned, this lifts up and it gives us access into the dinghy garage with a little stainless steel ladder that drops down. Quite nice. And then we're moving our way over to the starboard helm. And as we get to the starboard helm, there is a lot to do over here, and but it's not intimidating. It's set up again quite nice, and I really enjoy how Jeanneau and the naval architects, especially Philippe Brion and his inputs to the Jeanneau design team with Eric Stromberg, have set this up. And so what we have here is we have our autopilot control unit, so standby, auto. We can control you know, the degrees of turns. We have our multi-repeater that we have the same thing that's on our port helm. Then we have our nav lights, spreader lights, our deck light, and then our second jib furling system. This is the in and out for the jib furler. Our Volvo Penta engine display here. And then we have our stern and bow thruster controls. So this is huge. This was one of the very first Jeanneau 57/58 that had this option. And this allows you to put the boat completely sideways, to put the bow to starboard or port and your stern to starboard, turn the boat in a 360. This is impressive. This is a nice system and a huge upgrade. And then we also have our windlass control counter, so we can deploy, retrieve our anchor from here. It'll also tell us how much we've weighed out. So again, really nice system. And then we have our Volvo Penta engine controls right here. So very easy to get to, very accessible. And then the same on the port side, our Jeanneau fast and slow, main fast and slow control switches led there. So really simple, impressive, well designed. Double propane system tank here. One they kind of set up for a barbecue, which is right off the stern rail. Second one is set up for the oven down below. Underneath this is that lazarette that I was telling you that houses the life raft, the safety gear, the ditch bag, you know, your emergency tiller, your backup furling system for the Facnor electric furler. Again, this owner is really organized and very well detail oriented. This is the ignition switch. So this is controlled with a fob, but this is the ignition switch that, you know, powers up the engine controls, and then you start, you stop it from here. So again, you can see this powered up our display here, 519 hours. So very, very light use, easy one touch, fires right up. You know, with this Volvo, you can barely hear that it's running, but really impressive system here. While I'm here, I don't talk about this very much, but this is the Jeanneau plaque. This is the CE certification that Jeanneau gives. This is Class A. This is full offshore around the world, 13 people with all their luggage, B, C, and D. C and D are up to 16 people, but this is a very high classification for a high amount of people. So we are on a true, you know, offshore cruiser, and it's labeled that, you know, by CE. Centrally located here, this is our Raymarine plotter. This is a flat touchscreen display, very large. As you can see, all of these flashing lights, this is all the AIS. So these are all the boats with AIS signals. Here we are in Marina del Rey. The exit channel is right down here. So this is one of the best slips in Marina del Rey, and potentially is transferable as well too, if so desired. We have large seating with backrest cushions here, an amazing cockpit table, teak that's been varnished. It's like a satin look to it. We have a built-in refrigerator here and a built-in kind of storage glove box on this side. The leaves fold up on both sides, so you have these beautiful, you know, teak slotted leaves. There's also this huge stainless steel kick bar here. So instead of people, like, you know, putting their feet on the table to balance, you have this big stainless steel kick bar. And again, very well designed with the integrated cup holders, hand holds. Making our way up, we do have additional hand holds here on the Dodger. We talked about the electric cabin top winches, but these are electric rewind winches. So Harkin has developed a power in, power out mode, and a two speed. So depending on which way you pull this trigger, you can have power in and out. So, you know, just a lot of versatility here. You have our outhaul, our halyards, general halyards all set up with lots of open clutches. And then off to the starboard side, spin halyard, outhaul, vang. And this is also a Harkin rewind winch. I like how Jeanneau has done this open box here. Look at this clever little contraption here with non-skid built on it. So you can have your working sheets down in there if so desired. Cockpit lighting as well too. And let's flow on to this companionway. So the companionway has these doors that just open up. They're on this track system. I mean, look at this entryway. This is huge. And it takes us down into the salon itself. But as we get too far, I'll kind of sit here down on this and just really give you a perspective of just how seriously amazing this yacht is. And I really find it to be open. It's light. It's airy. This is that classic teak interior with white oak floors. Really, really nautical, traditional styling. So here is our galley. Now, the galley has this large, you know, almost encompassing a countertop space with lots of storage. There's storage down below the flooring as well too, but this will just give you a quick glimpse of just how much storage there really is on this vessel. We have all of these that open up for spices and just additional storage. Our Bose Cube speaker, they've done, this was I believe the first year that they did the white lacquered on the top to just kind of make it a little bit more bright and airy. And then they brought this Corian into this lower cabinet. So all these small touches, talking about small touches, look at the dampeners, you know, on the cabinet doors. They've just done a really impressive job, with the construction. Three burner stove and oven. This slides back, gets out of your way. We have an overhead vent hood with an integrated light and multiple speed fans. This large window here, these are ocean air shades that lift up out of the way, close down for privacy if you so desire. We have the top loading and side loading fridge access here. So small freezer compartment there. And these racks that are really clever, so stuff just doesn't go falling out. So you have these, everything built in these racks that slide out as well too. So that's a nice design in itself. And then a very deep refrigerator that could also be thermostated, I don't even know if that's a word, down to make this a refrigerator. In my videos, you're gonna see lots of made up words, but I just roll with it because there's just so much to show you here. So anyways, yeah, look at all the storage and cabinet space galore. Built-in microwave as well too. 110 outlet hidden back there. And then we have the manual foot pump. That's down below. So this is fresh and or salt water with a little valve. And then we have, you know, just our traditional sink, double stainless steel sink. So that's a split there. This is kind of neat. This is a dish drying area. It has a built-in drain. I've even seen some of my clients fill this full of ice and champagne. So do as you wish. But again, it's a really nice compliment there. You know, shelving. This has all of the self closing dampeners on them as well too. And yeah, again, it just goes on and built in trash can that slides out. So looking at the companionway stairs, we have engine access through here. You can also get engine access through this cabinet on the starboard side and from rear. Generator access is right underneath these two hatches that lift up. So you have full accessibility to your Onan generator down here, which is also in its own sound shield. Now, since we're here, we're gonna go directly across to the nav station. The nav station, this one is set up quite nice. This is all storage here with an opening a door. And we brought it in this way because some people will put a washer and dryer here. Then we have a foul weather locker here that has a built-in drain, but they also have an ice maker. So if you wanted an ice maker, we can reinstall it. It's all the plumbing's there for you, but that's where that would go. This also lifts up so you can see just, again, there is just real estate after real estate of storage on this yacht. And really just clever little areas here. Yeah, more storage, access to points, but you're looking at a yacht with so many systems and you're saying, how could this possibly be? You know, this is all of the controls for that. Well, Jeanneau's done really nicely to keep it simple. And what I love about it is you have like your main switches that you turn on here, like electronics, one switch, all your electronics fire up. You know, refrigerator, one switch, freezer, one switch, your lighting. The simple stuff is right here. These are all our battery monitoring. Now, this particular yacht has 12 volt and 24 volt banks on it. We also have multiple tank readouts and multiple water holding, what have you. Actually, holding is not red, but just water tanks that are here. But back here is where they put all of the technical systems. So your ship to shore breakers, your generator and inverter switch down here. This is the remote switch for the generator itself, remote switch for the inverter. Then we get to kind of like our 110, I call it the 115. So 115 and then our 220 stuff. So all of our heavy loads like the air conditioning and what have you, those are all up top here. And then our outlets and so forth are down below like the microwave. But that is all hidden, but it keeps this really simple and there's really no necessary need to really mess with those too much unless you're switching over from ship to shore. But yeah, that's pretty straightforward. Then we have our VHF that's here at the nav station as well too. But when you're sitting here, which I will so you can get a good perspective at eye level, I mean, take this all in. This is gorgeous. There are four overhead opening hatches here. I've left just because of the sun at this angle right now and the time of day, I've left those shades, you know, kind of drawn. But look how open and inviting. You're sitting here, you can actually see down at the water and you have lots of overhead, just light, just flooding the salon. And it is quite nice. We have this bench seat off to the port side, additional storage. We have access here to our Fusion stereo. This is our Bose stereo system, our Sony Blu-ray player here, our air conditioning remote that's located here. And yeah, that's done nicely. iPod docking station. So all this is kind of set up. We have a great surround sound entertainment system, Samsung flat screen television, and yeah, full surround sound, as I mentioned. But beautiful. This is the chocolate leather. So this is a really was a popular color and a popular choice by the French designers. And then a little hidden bar here, and then down below this is a hidden bar. And when I flip this cushion over, you can see this is a leather inlay. This becomes a little built-in coffee table when that's flipped over. But great use of space there. Behind us here, this is our controls for our water maker. Now, the water maker can be set up in a couple different, so you can go 24 volt and or off the generator itself. They still label it 230, but whatever. There's been 3.7 hours ran on it. So again, this is virtually brand new there. And this particular owner has lots of spares that go with the vessel. Little hidden storage there as well too. And here we go, looking at the starboard side of the salon. They have these, I'm gonna pronounce it wrong, but Dendon chairs. These are collapsible, very high-end, very expensive. I've quoted them out for some clients, but very comfortable, I should say. These two chairs, they do float around. They do collapse down so they can be out of your way. You can take them to the swim step if you so desire and just lounge out on them. This salon table does drop down to a coffee table. There is a remote switch right here above the second salon air conditioning control. So that'll lower down. It'll also slide back and forth depending on how you want to use it. Additional storage there. Also, we have built-in grab handles that are here. But yeah, what a remarkable salon, nice and open. Here we are going into something a little bit different. Because this is a master aft, and I'm saving that for last, but because it's a master aft, we have three staterooms up forward and or the possibility to doing a VIP cabin. And so if it's set up in this fashion, you can see the bed is kind of Pullman style here. You put your head here, your feet down there. Two people can easily sleep in there. But what also happens is when the wall that's stowed below here is put into place, this lifts up and extends the bed with a filler cushion, turns it into a queen mattress, and really makes this a VIP cabin. And we have double bunk beds on this side, storage hanging locker here, and lots of overhead storage as well too. But when this is pulled up, filler cushion is in, this makes into a queen size berth. Then when you flip on this side, this backrest, you know, or this second bunk folds down, turns into a backrest. Now you have a vanity, you have a couch, you have just amazing amount of storage, seating, and it truly is impressive creating this a VIP cabin and or with the wall that gets put into place with seven pieces. So there are three pieces down below, one center locking piece, and three pieces above that are all stowed below this bed. That gets put into place and you have really two nice cabins here with their own head and shower compartments. This one's set up a little bit nicer because the first owner had actually taken it off, but and it's stowed underneath the bed, but there's a plexiglass little divider that will encompass this shower. But you have a nice shower faucet here. You have your Japsco quiet flush toilets. Another thing I want to point out is we've also converted them to fresh water and salt. So if you're offshore, flip this switch and now the salt water pump will activate it and you won't use any of your fresh water supply. But they are push button electric toilets, and that is a nice offshore feature. Sinks, mirror, you know, additional cabinet space, you know, just a nice VIP cabin head. All right, so now we're gonna go up to the guest cabin head. So again, when this wall is in place and here's the channel here, they have their own head and shower compartment here. Same thing, all the toilets have the fresh or salt water capabilities. They're all Japsco quiet flush toilets. You have a shower faucet that pulls up out of the sink, locks into this position here. Your shower sump is down below. Obviously, you're taking showers with this door closed, and yeah, it's nice. This wood is all waterproof, zero maintenance whatsoever. So if you do get it wet, just wipe it dry. It's not a big deal. And then we have our V berth up forward. So accessibility can be from up top. You have a nice V berth here. I've had some clients turn this into, you know, a full workbench, storage room, laundry facilities. I mean, you name it, anything's possible up here. And or crew quarters, as I mentioned. And with the crew quarters, they would gain access right from the top. They would sleep here and they would have this head and or they would share it. So it's totally up to you and how you, you know, kind of lay it out. But if you have a big family or two or three families on board and you just want that versatility, this boat offers so much of that. You know, it really is impressive. And as I was talking earlier about the mast, this is the mast down below here. That's right on one of the built-in integrated third generation grid hole structure designs. And that's sitting right on top of that. And that's where our keel bolt starts. So our keel pretty much starts from here and works our way aft. You know, our keel has been moved up forward, our rudder aft, the balance, the stability, the turning radius on this yacht is truly impressive. All right, so this will give you a good kind of perspective looking aft, and we are going to come into the aft cabin, which I was saving for you guys. So here in the aft cabin, we have the door that steps down, and check this out. This is utilizing the entire beam of the vessel. We have a hanging locker storage here. There's a built-in safe down below that. And huge hanging locker, lots of space. We have a forward-facing vanity, a large bench seat here. Notice again, they brought in this accordion trim on all of this storage. You have escape hatches on both starboard and port side. Lots of storage and this incredible Marine Queen centerline berth. Engine access from down here, additional storage. You know, we did a large mirror. This was something that we did after the fact. And then, the safe is built in here, not on the cabinet, but yeah, built-in safe. And look at these, like, kind of like Chester drawers, or I mean, I don't know how you would call it, but just additional storage and cabinet throughout. I mean, it just, it's impressive. It just goes on and on. So this boat does not lack storage. It is cool. When these are all opened up, you get this huge cross ventilation in through the entire boat itself. And then we have accessibility to our head and shower compartment. So Japsco quiet flush toilet, these really beautiful sinks here, nice fixtures, faucets, huge shower with this plexiglass door that kind of encompasses the shower area, but a remarkable aft cabin and just so much to kind of go over, to talk about, to kind of show you here. Another set of air conditioning controls here as well too. And now we're back into the salon. Well, I hope you found that extremely long video on my part, I'm sorry, helpful and informative. If you would like more information in regards to seriously the 2015 Jeanneau 57 LLC owned, please feel free to contact myself at any time, day or night. This is an absolute pristine offshore cruiser that is fully turnkey with all the bells and whistles. I hope you saw some of them. I didn't talk about a lot of them, but again, we can talk in more detail. Give it a thumbs up if you liked the video. Subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you for watching. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business. Thank you again.